please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
There's Mr. Rana Kapoor detailing out the third quarter at Yes Bank.
Short delay because of our board meeting just got over. Just to start the commentary on our results, foremost, I'm very happy to announce that this quarter, December 31st, 2017, has been historic for Yes Bank, at least on two very major accounts. One is our total assets, our total balance sheet for the first time in our entire life cycle, in our evolution, has crossed 2,50,000 crores. Our advances also crossed 1,50,000 crores for the first time, and this happens to be our 51st quarter. The total capital funds of the bank now have aggregated to an amount of 43,596 crores, so which translates into an overall capital adequacy CRAR of 19.5% and a overall Tier 1 ratio of 14.7% and a CET 1 ratio of 10.7%. So overall increase in capital funds year on year has been 62.3%. The bank has approximately added about $2.5 billion over the last approximately five quarters to capital funds. And as you can see, the overall capital adequacy is almost at an all-time high of 19.5%, allowing the bank to grow steadily in the future. Our growth in advances was fairly high, overall 46.5%, given the comeback in corporate growth, fairly robust corporate growth, accompanied by augmentation of retail banking advances, which have more than doubled in the last 1 year to 11.8%. And along with MSME advances now aggregate to about 32.3% compared to 31.1% about a year ago. The asset quality of the bank for this quarter continued to be stable, and the aggregate credit cost of the bank for the full year now is 64 basis points, and for the quarter specifically, it was 18 basis points. I'm also pleased to share with you that Yes Bank is the first bank to establish a medium-term note, MTN program, on the global securities market in India, which is part of the India International Exchange at the GIFT City in Gandhinagar. We are also happy to report that Yes Bank in December was included in the S&P BSE Sensex for the first time in its life cycle, having been a part of the NSE Nifty for over 2 years now. The bank also on international indices such as MSCI, ESG, SRI was included for the first time based on very strong operating performance on environmental, social and governance parameters. Moving on to profit and loss key data points. As you will see, that our total profit for this quarter once again exceeded 1,000 crores. The first time we did that was in September when we just crossed the border of 1,000 at 1,003. For December, this number has gone up quite significantly now to 1,077 crores, which is a growth of 22% compared to the corresponding period last year. I do want to mention that this 22% in itself is fairly significant if you really look at the impact on the treasury gains, which was fairly large in the corresponding period compared to the corresponding period. And so 22% factors in the adverse impact on Treasury as a result of a significant shift in the yield curve in the quarter gone by. Net interest income of the bank was 1,888 crores, representing a growth of 26.8%. Non-interest income was extremely robust, grew very robustly at an overall level of 1,422 crores, representing a year-on-year growth of almost 40%. Total net income was 3,311 crores, representing an increase of 32.1%. Operating profit was at 2,002 crores, representing an overall growth of 37.7%. NIMs were fairly healthy compared to last year at the same level, 3.5%. And the cost-to-income ratio was at 39.5%. On NIM, I do want to mention that the bank was somewhat impacted by about 10 basis points as a consequence of very significant bond raising, perpetual bonds of almost 5,415 crores, which were AA rated and raised at 9%, plus Tier 2 bonds of 4,000 crores that have been raised in the last quarter, which were priced at 7.8%. Their pricing looks very good compared to the current yield curve, you know, shifts that have taken place. But the blended cost of this on the cumulative amount of these Basel III compliant bonds, 9,415 crores, was 8.5% compared to our base cost of funds, which is around 6 to 6.1%. So there is a temporary dip, and it is most likely that given the overall growth curve of the bank, given the CASA accretion, which is looking extremely satisfactory, and given more organic production of PSL, which is happening, that we'll be able to achieve our objective, medium-term objective, of getting to 4% NIM no later than March 2020. I do expect it to happen sooner, but our objective is no later than March 2020. So overall, if you see, the ROAs of the bank were at 1.7% and the ROE at 18%, even though we raised capital just about 3 quarters ago. The book value of the split share, the 2 rupee share since September, is now at 106.8 rupees. On a cumulative basis, I do want to mention that the overall profit of the bank is 3,045 crores. So in 9 months, we have pretty much crossed 3,000 crores PAT, which is an increase of 26% compared to the corresponding 9 months of fiscal 16-17. So as you can see, the P&L has demonstrated fairly sustained delivery, and our operating outcomes and metrics continue to be extremely strong. On balance sheet, overall, as you can see, the bank is increasing its market share and also improving the overall granularity of our loan portfolio. The overall total assets of the bank grew by 36.2% to a level of 2,65,432 crores. So we are now a medium-sized large bank in our country. And this, as I mentioned to you, is a very significant milestone in our life cycle to get to this level. And we are hoping that in a couple of quarters, you know, we get to well past 3 lakh crores. Deposits grew correspondingly by 29.7% to an overall level of 1,71,000 crores. CASA ratio stood at 38%, which is an overall improvement of 4.7% in 1 year. And this, I think, is our single biggest balance sheet success, that 2 years in a row, the bank has been able to improve CASA quite dramatically by almost 5%. In the last 1 year, it's grown by 4.7%. And this is on the back of CASA growth, year-on-year growth of 48%, as you can see. Within this, SA stands at about 42,684 crores, and CA is about 22,600 crores. And SA has grown in the last 1 year by 45.4%, and CA has grown by 53% year-on-year. CASA plus retail FDs now account for approximately 61% of our total liability construct. As I mentioned, that advances too crossed a very significant milestone of 1.5 lakh crores and stand at 1,71,515 crores approximately, growing by 46.5% year-on-year on the back of a fairly steady contribution by both corporate and retail businesses. The total capital adequacy I've already mentioned. Our overall capital ratio is extremely strong. RWA, the risk-weighted assets, stood at 2,23,680 crores, which is overall 84.3% RWA to total assets. On the asset quality key numbers, the gross NPA was at 1.72, which is improved by about 10 basis points compared to September. Sequentially, it has improved by 10 basis points. September was a tough quarter on asset quality for us, but we've been able to show in a short span of time, almost effectively in 2 months, a 10 basis points on a much larger balance sheet, and an improvement of 11 basis points in the net NPA, which has improved from 1.02% to 93 basis points compared to the sequential September 2017 quarter. As I mentioned, the credit cost was contained at a fairly reasonable level of only 18 basis points, and cumulatively for the 9 months period till December 17 stands at 64 basis points. The provisioning coverage of the bank is around 46.4%, which is improved by about 3.1% compared to September when it stood at 43.3%. I do want to mention here that overall, we have, you know, NPAs which are not necessarily very sticky. So through a combination of improving provisioning and a reduction of NPAs that we contemplate in the next couple of quarters, certainly in the March quarter, and then followed well into June quarter, we do expect to get to 60% provisioning, in my assessment, no later than June of 2018. As I mentioned to you, our NPAs are not static, they're not sticky, and therefore the efforts which are being made by management and our leadership will ensure that through a combination, we achieve a provisioning target of 60% no later than June of 2018. And I'm sure there will be a question on the guidance for credit costs for 2018-19. I hope you wait till April. We still have one more quarter to go. I think overall, as you can see, the composition of the balance sheet is pretty much the same. We are roughly about 67.7% corporate banking, but fairly diversified across our eight corporate businesses, which are fairly segmented and fairly diversified. In our retail and business banking functions, we are roughly about 32.3% in aggregate. But the good thing within the overall composition is that the retail banking, the more granular business, which is managed by Pralay and one of his leaders, Rajan Pental, this has shown fantastic growth. We now stand at 11.8% compared to 8.6%, you know, 1 year ago. And even sequentially, this composition, despite a very large contribution of corporate growth, has improved from 11.4% to 11.8% sequentially. Moving on to the more sensitive areas of asset quality, starting first with the sensitive sector disclosures. As you know, we've been fairly consistent in showing you our various exposures. Overall, I want to share with you that the sensitive sectors that we classify really as electricity, which is really non-renewable power, largely thermal, iron and steel, where there is still a fat tail, you know, risk outstanding. And somewhat, we also believe that there is a there's a residual risk, very, very small, almost at its...
Okay, so that's Mr. Rana Kapoor talking about the growth. It has been a good quarter for Yes Bank, and interestingly, promising that they will move to about 60% provisioning levels by June of 2018, saying that their NPAs, at least a large chunk of their NPAs, are not sticky bad loans. That is the promise coming in from Yes Bank. We're completely out of time on this edition of Closing Bell.